Resolving bank feed errors in QuickBooks might appear simple if you know the process thoroughly. In this video, we will tell you how you can resolve some of the most common QuickBooks bank feed errors effectively. So, let's get started. 1. QuickBooks Bank Error 103. What is it? When the credentials you enter into QuickBooks Online don't match what your financial institution possesses, you'll get error 103. The most common causes are erroneous credentials being entered and selecting the incorrect financial institution. How to fix it? If you're connecting for the first time, confirm that you can log into your bank outside of QuickBooks by going to your bank's website and manually entering your credentials, instead of allowing your computer to autofill it. If you can access your bank's website, try connecting through QuickBooks again, this time manually entering your credentials. If the problem persists, follow the steps below to reconnect. Select Add Account from the banking option on the left. Note, if you already have a bank account in your chart of accounts, you can connect it by going to the Action column and selecting View Register or Account History from the drop-down menu. Enter the complete name of the bank you're seeking to connect to or the bank's URL in the search area. If many results appear, choose the bank name for your account from the list. Enter your user ID and password to log in. If you get the error 103 again, do the following. Go back to the previous name on the list and select the next name on the list. Repeat this step until you've found the correct website under the bank's name and connected to your account successfully. Number 2. QuickBooks Bank Error 108. What is it? Error code 108 occurs if there are changes on your bank that need your action. In other words, the bank sends you a notice that requires you to take action. If you're having trouble logging into your bank account, it could be due to a variety of factors, such as an incorrect username or password. Another reason could be that the user is having trouble connecting to the bank server. How to fix it? Method 1. Disable the pop-up blocker. The first step is to visit the bank's or financial institution's website and log in. The user must now go through all of the notifications or messages that have been received. The pop-up blocker could be the cause of the user's inability to read the messages. As a result, the user must disable it before checking his or her messages. The following step is to either act on or dismiss the communications. The user must browse QuickBooks after completing the preceding steps. Moving on, the user should select Banking from the left-hand menu. In the banking page, the user must now press the Update button. If the error persists and you continue to receive Banking Error 108, proceed to the next troubleshooting method. Method 2. Try to run the System File Checker. First, go to the Start menu and type Command into the search field. After that, the user must simultaneously press the Ctrl plus Shift keys before pressing the Enter key. The user will now be presented with a permission dialog box, which they must accept by clicking Yes. Moving forward, the user will see a dark box with a blinking cursor appear. The user must then input SFC Scan Now and then press the Enter tab. After you've completed the above steps, the System File Checker will begin scanning. At last, perform on-screen instructions to proceed further. Number 3. QuickBooks Bank Error 353. What is it? QuickBooks prompted you to renew the bank connection, error code 353. How to fix it? You can try to update your bank account to refresh the connection. The below help you how. Navigate to the banking section. Click Update after selecting the bank account. Enter your multi-factor authentication, MFA, credentials if required and then click the Continue Update tab. Number 4. QuickBooks Bank Error 192. What is it? Error 192 indicates that your bank requires additional sign-on information, which stops QuickBooks from downloading banking transactions automatically. In some situations, accessing your bank account requires entering an ever-changing code. However, there are numerous occasions when users come up with QuickBooks Bank error 192 because of Windows Framework records damage. How to fix it? Check out the solutions to easily get rid of banking error 192. Solution 1, verify the account information. From the QuickBooks Lists menu, select the Chart of Accounts tab. Choose the account name that you're using when you receive QuickBooks Bank error 192 message. In the Chart of Accounts window, click on the Account button, which is at the bottom of the list. After done with that, select the Edit menu. Now, click on the Online Services tab when you enrolled in QB with an Edit account. And then make sure that the number in the customer ID field which matches the username that you have chosen. Make sure there are no dashes or spaces in your account number. Make sure your routing number is correct by looking it up online. If the above solution will not work, then try Manual Restore, Advanced Computer User Solution. Number 5. QuickBooks Bank Error 323. What is it? QuickBooks Error 323 is a banking error that often occurs when you sign in credentials that you entered which are not being accepted by your financial institution's website. This can happen if you've two accounts with the same account name and the same account number, or when you added the same account two times. How to fix it? To overcome QuickBooks Bank Error 323, try the following solutions. Solution 1. Rename one of the accounts at bank's website. First, go to the banking menu in the navigation bar. Select account which you wish to rename. Next, select the Edit menu, Edit Account Info. Now, choose the option named Disconnect this account on Save in the account window. In the end, select the Save button. Solution 2. Download the required transactions. Initially, open the settings, then select Setup Transaction Download. Next, select the option My Bank is not listed in order to update the bank list. It will display the current date when the list is updated. Now, move to the Show List, enter the name of your bank, enter login credentials, continue. A list of all accounts with bank details will pop up on your screen. In the end, connect each of the accounts to the appropriate account you've created. Number 6. QuickBooks Bank Error 187. What is it? Error code 187 occurs when the wrong answer was given for the two-factor authentication, 2FA, question that was asked. The error message usually pops up when users are attempting to import transactions into QuickBooks from your bank due to improper software uninstalls or missing files that were accidentally deleted from the Windows registry. How to fix it? Check out the list of solutions for how to fix QuickBooks Banking Error 187. Solution 1. Select the Banking tab from the left menu. Next, click on the Update button from the upper right-hand corner. Click on the option to clear unwanted accounts if you only want to update some of your accounts. Now, click on the Update Now button. After that, enter the credentials of multi-factor authentication, MFA, if prompted. In the end, click on the Continue Update tab. Solution 2. Select the banking option from the left menu. Next, click on the Update button which appears on the upper right-hand corner. Under the last updated column, you can see the date and time of the last update will be listed. Number 7. QuickBooks Bank Error 591. What is it? Users experience this kind of QB banking error 591 when they are trying to connect Santander and Kahoot, UK, accounts in QuickBooks Online, QBO. How to fix it? Moreover, Keeping your account updated also helps users to resolve the banking error 591 as soon as possible. Let's see how. Go to the banking section of the menu. Choose from two options: upload transactions or upload from a file. Select the file you downloaded from your bank by clicking Browse or Select Files. Then choose between Next and Continue. Select the account you wish to upload the transactions to from the QuickBooks account drop-down menu. Then hit the Next button. To match the columns on the file with the correct fields in QuickBooks, follow the on-screen instructions. Again hit the Next button. Choose the transactions which you want to import and then choose Next. Moving further, Yes should be selected. Select the Let's Go when you're ready. After you've imported your transactions, you'll need to examine and/or match them to the current records in QuickBooks. This is to ensure that your data is correct. Hope you have resolved your QuickBooks Bank feed error. So, if you feel this video was helpful for you, then hit the like button and subscribe to our channel for more such videos. If you want to learn more about such topics, please let us know in the comments section below.